Brad, welcome to your new home.
Are you kidding me? Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me? Do you see this? In storms I was cold. We have a home. I've been around the world and back again. Don't need to see
more. Oh, maybe I was never lost at all. It's amazing.
Hey, buddy. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Magnum, thank you.
You know, a lot of hard work, man, but you're the one who deserves the thanks.
What I thought.
Hey, next time, trust us, all right?
Hell yeah.
I'm really busy. I got a garage full of cars. Why don't we skip this interrogation 101 crap and get right to the point?
You still have the Navy SEAL combat knife that was issued to you when you joined your unit?
I gave it to my father to gut his deer the day he was killed. That's the last time I saw it.
Well, it just turned up, stuck in the back of a dead woman's skull.
We think she's the person responsible for your father's murder.
Well, when you catch a killer, be sure to thank him for me.
Mr. McHenry, whoever killed her was highly skilled. This person was able to render a trained assassin helpless and a torturing murderer. Presumably all by himself.
Person capable of that might have had extensive military training. What do you think?
What do I think? I'm not going to let you stand here and accuse me of murder.
We're not accusing you. I'm trying to understand how your knife ended up at our crime scene.
You're disappointed, Detective. I can see it in your eyes. Come here expecting a big, strong Navy SEAL killing machine? Instead, you get half a soldier.
What I see is motive.
What do you know?
More than you think.
Don't you dare pity me.
It ain't pity, Russ. I'm just trying to figure out if you could have done it.
What? Because of these? 20 different ways, Detective. Trust me. But come on, leaving my knife behind? That's sloppy. If you know anything about Navy SEALs, we're not sloppy. I'll tell you this, though. If I would have known who killed my father, yeah, I would have done it.
I still smoke. Can't be too mad at it, because it kind of saved my right hand.
How so?
When I got blown up, I had both of my hands on the bottom of the steering wheel, and right before the explosion went off, I took my hand off, grabbed a cigarette, stuck it in my mouth. When I went to go light it, the explosion happened. And it took the whole bottom of the steering wheel and my left hand off. And I was lucky that I had this. I mean, still fucked up my right hand, but
yeah,
I still got it.
And you still smoke.
Yeah, I still smoke.